chenfunye museno lwa kubanga ndi nawe ngasi kulina mukama mboyana uli chembale change lwa kubanga ndi nawe chensaba museno berana nge wenkuva ko chitange mboyana Fana na makumba mchivovu Mbulwe subi, mbulwe mirembe Chensaba museno Chingu ya museno ndita yeka Wakati mumizira mkulabe sebo Wate bintu byensi bisikiriza Wate bintu byensi binyuma Chesaba sebo obera nange
Yesu, vera nange Thank you. nothing into the world, and we take out nothing. The Lord has given, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. In these moments of sorrow, the Lord is with us. He consoles us with these words. Jesus himself said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. Because in my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also." Take your seats and let us pray. Father, of all mercies, and God of all comfort, you embrace us with the arms of love. In the shadow of death, your light shines on us. We remember before you our brother Charles. May we, with him and all the saints, inherit your eternal kingdom, and rest with you in light and peace. We pray all this through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. You may turn to your books and let's join in the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom. You, only God, you are immortal, the creator and maker of all. We, humans, are mortal, formed of the earth, and earth we shall return. For so you ordained when you created us, saying, "You will dust, and dust you shall return." God of grace, we profit one another, especially for the family, friends, and all who are concerned in this passing moment. Be our comfort in our loss and sorrow. Be our refuge and strength, and enfold us in your everlasting arms. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now may we stand to sing the first hymn, "Great is Thy Faithfulness."
to your six friends, and let's have the first reading by Sarah Nansenke.
Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I'm convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that's in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Abaana ba Katonda, mwebale bannange kujja mu bungi. I'm sorry, I'm tuning to CBS Bulange, Uganda for the time being. If in case you are seated with someone who can translate this language of mine, it's Chinese actually. So if you are sitting next to someone who can translate, I'm just going to be very brief. Abaana ba Uganda, abaana ba Kintu. Mukama Yaise Charles. May we stand to sing. I think we are going to be led by the stewards. Ompise Mukama, translated, the Lord has called me. Lord, you have called me. May we stand to sing. If you can join in, it's just a hymn.
To my fellow believers, when it seems as though you are facing nothing but difficulties, see it as an invaluable opportunity to experience the greatest joy that you can. Three, for you, know that when your faith is tested, it just stirs up in you the power of endurance. Four, and then as your endurance grows even stronger, it will release perfection into every part of your being until there's nothing missing and nothing lacking. Five, and if anyone longs to be wise, ask God for wisdom, and he will give it. He won't see your lack of wisdom as an opportunity to scold you over your failures, but he will overwhelm your failures with his generous grace. Shall separate us from the love of Christ. Shall troubles or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword.
Thank you. Now can we have Sylvia Kyazze, please? Take Sylvia. Is Sylvia here?
Oh. Don't let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. My father's house has many rooms. If they were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I'm going. Jesus, the way to the Father. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you're going. So how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I'm the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
I happened to be one of the choir he last joined and participated in. Nagisanga choir, Eva Stewart, ngeyimba nga mulimu besi. Nalibi okuyimba omujozi nga nguzizayo. Nebe nagenda okuwulira besi afubutuka mu choir. Ningamba niona chale nyinga besi yange, nange nengenda nenyingira kwaya. Nilitandika kwesa bwenyi. Era nze mu nsi mbadde mumanyimu abantu babiri abalina besi okuva ku gimu katundu nga yagenda. Babiri, Kyazze nange. Naye, Katakurumaya. We are going to have sharing Kyazze. Like, Dad and daughter, we are going to have Sharin now, just giving us a little bit of the talent she has inherited from the dad. Sharin.
I was just myself a very young boy. My name is Sharin Louis Bakula Bakwanako, and I'm Kyazze. Along with the suffering you are enduring with. Mum, your sister, there. She guided the path you walked, giving you the opportunity to build fine memories with your children and with hers. She gave you the opportunity to say your final goodbyes and let you finally open your eyes. She then reached out to heaven and took your hand, saying, Charles, it's time to join your family once again. Standing with her was your beloved mother, Angela, who got to hold her son once again. Butterflies flying around, I see them gently, barely touch the ground. Their presence made me feel at ease, as their wings flap in the leaves. They say my angels are among me, I see them daily fly right by me. There's something about these butterflies that always seems to catch my eye. It's almost as if I was meant to fly. With all these beautiful butterflies, they fly in past time to let me know they're watching over me. I miss you and I love you, Uncle. That's beautiful. And the song that I'm going to sing, it's a song I wrote called Beautiful Savior. It's one of my favorite, my dad's favorite songs that I've heard. I'm not lying, so anything. So if it's okay, I'm going to teach you the chorus. I didn't sing it, I'm going to do that okay? So it's the bit that's in blue, so it's kind of easy for you to read it.
You said, oh, Savior, our Lord and Jesus Christ. Our dad was a believer, a Christian. And especially as Easter was just around the corner, I think it's important to know that death is not the end. That death was defeated by Jesus Christ. So we're going to sing this song. I don't know if there's an organ accompanying me or if I'm a cappella. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to continue to talk while Jerome is there. Okay. Oh, no, it's okay, Jerome can play. It's down there. It's okay. It's okay, Jerome knows the song.
Beautiful Savior, I can see you died on the cross. Beautiful Savior, I can see your blood was shed for me. He said, oh, I will never leave you alone. See, I am seated on
the throne.
Don't you know? Beautiful Savior, I can see your heart on the cross for me. Beautiful Savior, I can see his hands, the wounds that say. He is seated on.
Another clap, please. Please, please. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Yes, observing the protocol, because I'm a Uganda. Nyaniriza abakungu basabasajja mwena. Nyaniriza mwena sabasajja. Biyagole omukono abavunaanyizibwa mu biti eby'enjawulo. Nyaniriza abalangira n'abambejja. Nyaniriza abantu ba Ssaabasajja mwenna. Nyaniriza abaana be Uganda mwenna. Nyaniriza mwenna abaana ba East Africa. Nyaniriza abaana ba Africa mwenna. Bobanga olabyewo yenna yenna ava mu Africa mugambe nti mutumidde. But in a special way I want to welcome special dignitaries, and I'm going to request someone seated next to that dignitary. I'm going to point to you, please just turn around and tell him Don't shake hands, but tell him or her that he or she is most welcome. The dignitary I'm talking about is that neighbor sitting next to you, please. Bless you. God bless you. Without taking time, we are coming to sign family tributes. And let's work on now. Raymond Chikoyo. Okay. So, probably let me invite Mama Katerina and the whole team, Abasola of God, to give tribute. Who's? Oh.
My name is Matthew Charles Nkuwe Kyazze. I'm along here with my sisters, Annette, Sharvia, and Shireen. Unfortunately, our brothers couldn't make it. We're here to represent Ian, Dias, and Richard as well. We'd like to thank all of you for coming to celebrate the life of our father, the late Charles Kitanda Kyazze. We are here on this special day, and I'm the youngest son of the late Charles. I was born in Ottawa, Canada, and I'm the son of Margaret Kyria Kyazze. I spent my early years with my father in the country, to be specific, Kentville, Ontario. Then over the years, we communicated mainly through Facebook and briefly through the phone. I recently had the pleasure of reconnecting with my father at my cousin's wedding in 2021. During that time, I was able to ask him some questions about his father, Matthew Nkuwe Kyazze. We spoke and we chatted, and I was able to connect and find out where this love of music that my siblings and I all share come from, with our grandfather being a conductor in Uganda. Thank you. After the devastating news of our father's passing, I gained access to more information about the upbringing, and his life in Canada. Comparing our interests, especially at my current age, I realized the undeniable influence of DNA. My father well, my mother told me very similar. In that case, I have love for the people I live with on a daily basis, from my family to my friends, as well as he did. Hearing the stories of Charles, I know he cared a lot for his people, even for his children who he may have not seen all the time. While I won't stand in front of you and share stories of him being truly amazing in my reality, I will continue to cherish the memories of those who do have those stories. I am thankful to have a final memory of my father when I saw him in London with my past girlfriend at the time last summer. He looked happy and healthy, and I will keep those memories alive for life. I hope we all understand how short life really is. And we need to learn from Charles. We need to communicate more and check in on each other, because we never know when that day will come. In the end, family is about forgiveness and patience. I am forever grateful to have all my siblings, and we plan to leave a greater legacy. Cheers to the People's Champion.
Thank you.
prayer, you would hear his bass. Mirembe, mirembe, ya Yesu, ya Yesu. Kyazze abadde muntu w'abantu bonna. Kyazze was a trade of all colors. Go to churches all around England. He has been there. I take this opportunity to invite my brother in the Lord, serving the Roman Catholic community from Uganda and all over East Africa and Africa, Father Balinya. He's got a lot to say about Charles. Without taking more time, Father Balinya, sebo jango be yuko tuganda.
Avoluganda mwena, chitalo inyo, chitalo dara, firwa onda fono, abade empaji za fe. Condolences to the family, friends and all of us gathered here this afternoon to bid farewell to a loved one. I interacted with the late on various occasions where he was usually as a master of ceremonies, either at first Holy Communion, confirmation, graduations, and the like. And he had a knack of organizing and communicating and putting occasions and events in good form and conducting them to his very best. Last Wednesday, Derby Radio had almost 3 hours of dedication to his life. Many people who were on that Zoom forum expressed their many memories and testimonies about his large heart. A man who was so community-oriented, offering selfless service to one and all. So he touched the lives of many of us. We thank God for the gift of his life, his service, and his contribution. When I learned of his illness last month, somebody sent me a message, and I was told he was so ill. Took the bus to the hospital, and I met him there. We had a chat. We prayed together. And him being a Catholic, I administered the sacrament of the sick to him. Because we believe that the sacraments are signs of God's presence in us or among us. So we accompany him in that sacrament. And the Lord, we must go to him. We pray that his work does not go or end in vain. He has made a big contribution and very positively helped us to know about humanity, to know about community, to know about service. and pray that his work may be answered and rewarded in the bosom of Abraham. May the Lord accompany you with the wife.
He has a tribute because he is one of the people who has looked after the spiritual welfare of the Kyazze family. Pastor Lincoln, Musumba.
Guys, recognize that the late Charles Kyazze was a very economical man. We have an Anglican, we have a Catholic, and he's a Pentecostal. Isn't life magnificently that way, that born a Catholic, influenced beyond his Catholic birth, and as far as I know, has been part of Woodworld Missions Church in Mitcham, and now we're in the Methodist Church. That could be purely a hiring situation, but I'm here to bring condolences to the family and to the whole community and to celebrate the life of an exuberant, energetic, impactful man. And some of us may not have known him as much as we could have, but we've known him by his children, particularly for us at Liberty Christian Fellowship on behalf of the church there. Just want to celebrate the life of a very bright, generous people. And so Harriet Katerega, who will be taking the mic in a few moments, has been a member of our church. And of course, through how we come, Gakulabako, Shireen, what were this? And she has grown up before us, and through their passion, we've had the opportunity to meet Charles. And so here we are. And when these huge events happen, when someone so prominent passes, we have an opportunity to pull together and remember how passing our lives are. But it's been amazing to hear that many tributes over the weeks as we have mourned his life and celebrated his impact, to know that he has traversed religious boundaries. He's even at his older, in his older years, had the passion to connect to his singing capacities and join a choir. And in his very last days, in the last chapter of his life, opened his heart and gave his life to Jesus. He was born again. This man was born again. And so it shows that you can never outgrow the call of God. Age should not keep us from finding God. The Bible says, seek for God while you are young. Because you see, when you get older, you get very complicated and you become set in your ways. And my celebration when I heard that Charles had found Christ in his latter years was what an incredible achievement, that we can still find God even in our latter years. And so our tribute and our comfort to each other that he's in a place now where there is no pain, where there is no anguish. And he has joined the choir of heaven, and the bass section is celebrating as we as we remember and say God bless him. So may God comfort the family across continents, North America, here in Britain, in Europe, and even in Africa. May God strengthen us. May we, even in our latter years, reconnect with our giftedness and find God in the rubble of so many events that can hit your life over the years and bring you to a place where you don't want to know God anymore. Thank God that even at old age, we can still find him. Even today, I pray that we do. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Bamungamba.
Mbeja. Mama.
Naimu mbeja tatila kutambula yeka. Yekale. Namu iti. Mani kwa mwuri fuka mbeja namu mwuri bachiri bakola. Oh. Mbani
kwe bazaba nange ukubala musa. Mwena mbichibi ya mwena. Tusani senyo. Okufuna omukisa oyinza okutafuta
representative of His Majesty
n'abakungu ba Kabaka bonna
and all the royal of the king
abakungu ba machachi abasumba bonna mu biti eby'enjawulo na sheba sheka bonna
leadership of the church and all the clergy including all the leaders of different religious sects
abooluganda n'abemikwano
ladies and gentlemen
twebaza nnyo okubeera ku lunaku luno
we are so grateful for this day
olutali lwangu twebaza okuba tumaze akaseera ne mujja okubeerako naffe.
A very unusual day that you've been able to come and be with us today.
Kakati nga sinabagenda wala mu byokwebaza njagala tusooke okubasomera oba okuyita mu Chelsea's biography abaana babadde bebaali allocated okukola ekintu kino naye baagiskipinze nga buli omwali n'ekitundu kyalina okusoma.
Before I go any further, please permit me to go through the biography of the late Charles Kyazze. It's the children who were meant to partake of that section, but it was omitted. But those who are present here, Shavia and I will be able to partake that position. I'm the one who has been around to bring them up.
No, Senga Wabana.
Auntie of the children is the one who brought them up. Am I right? Thank you.
Kakati kapchandike nemakula. Asomeji soka vyo nabi wandi kembutavo na ye katugenda kusoma section by section.
We'll begin with Makula as she reads the first section. Everything is recorded in the book.
Hello everybody. It's in the book. So I'm reading the early years in education section. So Charles was born in Usana Kulungu on the 31st of October 1957 to the late Matthew Nakue and the late Angela Namatovo. He was the second last born of the 15 siblings born to the couple. He studied at St. Augustine Kulungu Boys Primary and proceeded to study at the Bakalasa. Guys, I'm so sorry if I butcher some of these names. Please have mercy on me. Minor Seminary, Rubaga Boys Secondary School, and graduated from Caltech Academy from his high school. He studied at St. Augustine Kalungu Boys for primary. He proceeded to study at the Bukalasi Minor Seminary. Oh, is that the same thing again? Okay. Charles joined Makerere University for a bachelor's degree, and it is during his days at Makerere that he joined Alex Mukulu, a prominent Ugandan playwright, act in popular political theatrical drama. Muzukulu wa Kabangala, produced in 1977. And due to the political turmoil at the time, he was forced into exile and lived in Nairobi, Kenya. He then moved to Toronto, Canada, where he lived for 5 years, and later moved on and resettled in Ottawa, Ontario, where he studied theatre and film at York University.
He then moved to the United Kingdom and studied BA in sociology, an MA in sociology, and was pursuing a doctorate in sociology at the time of his demise.
Charles was a proved talented musician, singer, dancer, and recreational artist. He picked these talents from his father and also grandfather, who was an international gospel singer who had traveled throughout Africa and Europe spreading the gospel through music. Charles performed in over 15 productions as an actor with impact on an international level. He was also part of the choir, the stewards at his church, Power Center Church, and with World Missions until his passing.
Community and charity work. In Canada, Charles worked as an executive director at the African Resource Center and founded the Women and Children's Charity Organization in Ottawa. Within the UK, Charles worked and collaborated with various charities, including Uganda AIDS Action Fund, African Community Association, ASIA, Positive Care Link, PCL, Uganda Community Relief Association, UKRA, Baganda Women's Association, the French African Wear Association, FAWA, and many more. He also founded and worked as a manager at African Family Support Services from 1999 to 2002 in the UK, working with families affected by AIDS. Charles was dedicated to his work as an advocate, as a sociologist, a counselor, a mentor, and broadcaster. He worked with South London African Women's Organization since 2002, and he was in charge of training, fundraising, and research. He also worked and coordinated with the African Women's Organization, specifically Dr. Ifwe, to fighting female genital mutilation from the early 1990s. He also worked with Addington Afro-Ethnic, which was his main workplace before he became unwell.
Radio and presentation skills. Charles was a presenter, newsreader at Spectrum Radio 558 AM from 2000 to 2006. He was a presenter at 75 Derby Radio in London since 2020 to the day of his passing. He also took part in presenting and coordinating Power Centre Church Radio, which is the radio station funded by the church that Charles was attending until his passing.
His sickness. Charles was admitted to St. George's Hospital, suffering from diabetics with very low sugar levels. He had suffered what they called a hypo, and during his treatment investigations were carried out of his internal organs, and the scans highlighted another complication. After 3 weeks in the hospital, Charles was diagnosed with cancer of the bile duct, the tube that connects the liver, the gallbladder, and the pancreas together, draining bile into the intestines, called cholangiocarcinoma, which had also spread to the liver. Charles Kitanda Kyazze, 65 years old, passed away peacefully at St. Raphael's Hospice, London, UK, on Thursday evening, March 23, 2023. His daughter Shireen, nephew Raymond, and Mumbeja Harriet were by his side. Charles is survived by his sons Richard Kyazze, Ian, Matthew, Dias, and daughters Annette, Shireen, and Chavia. He's also survived by countless grandchildren and other children he has adopted in very many countries. His family wishes to express appreciation to St. George's Hospital, St. Raphael's Hospice, the Ugandan communities in UK and Canada, and all his close friends and well-wishers for helping make his transition to heaven a peaceful one. Charles Kitanda Kyazze, dad, uncle, husband, Mkwano Gwavanji, you have fought a good fight. We have lost a gem. rest in eternal peace. With that, I will just speak very briefly. Basically, before thanking you, I just to tell you a little bit about how Charles came to this country. I met Charles Kitanda Kyazze in 1991 in Canada, and we became friends, and the rest is history. But while I was in Canada, I decided, because I was a student as well in the University of Toronto, I decided I needed to come back to Britain to complete my accountancy course, SCCA. I'm a chartered certified accountant. So Charles was very supportive, and he bought me a ticket to come back to England. So Charles bought me a ticket, so I came back to England and studied. But I came to study one course, and I felt after that I needed to continue with my master's. Meanwhile, we are traveling between Canada and the UK. While in Canada, we found out we are pregnant with Makulaga Kulabako. So there was a fight about where she would be born. Charles wanted Makula to be born in Canada, and I wanted Makula to be born in the UK. I won. So I came to Canada. I mean, we came back and we had Makula in Canada, in the UK. And then I was studying as well, continued to. Basically, the plan was for me to go back to Canada, but I decided to not to go. And while I had a baby and I was doing my master's, Charles decided to come and join us. So really, I'm standing here because Charles came to the UK because of us. He came and joined us, and when he came, he struggled for 3 years. Charles didn't have a job. He tried to get a job for 3 years, and he failed. I introduced him to many charities. All these charities are first rate, but everywhere I took him to that, he would pop in and come back and say, Harriet, Mumbeja, you think I can work here? The reason why is because in Canada, they have everything big. He had a big office. Every 4 o'clock, all of them, the Canadian can witness to this, and the 4 o'clock, they would gather in the office, in the office room to watch Young and Restless. Yeah, that's what they do. They gather and then they go back to work. He came here, he was looking at these offices, very small, and he said, no, I'm not working here. I took him to different shops, but eventually, after 3 years of struggling, he decided, it grew on him that this is UK. We are small. We are big, but we are small. So he got his first contract from Uganda AIDS Action Fund. If Mr. Rubega is here, he would testify. He gave him his first contract as a charity worker. They were all very impressed because he was very knowledgeable. He was very humble. He did a lot of things. Then he went to UCRA. Then he went to ASIA, all these organizations, because I was already into the community, of course, you know, and the Baganda women. He helped us a lot. So really, that is a little bit I can tell you. And after some years, of course, things happened. I would like also, some of you may know, or some all may know, those who don't know, we had 6 children with Charles. 6 children, including twins. And the boy, Anthony, whom he named Anthony Chirabo Kyazze, he named him after his nephew in Canada, Anthony, is buried in Nunhead Cemetery behind a house. So we had 6 children, but things happened. Whatever happened, we did not mourn together. That's what I said. People grieve differently, and things, whatever. But we continue to be very good friends. And that's why I'm very grateful. I had to rise to this challenge to make sure that Mr. Kitanda Kyazze is given a dignified and respectable send-off. And thank you, community. I applaud you. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, all the charities, the Muslims, the Catholics, the Pentecostal, the Ethiopians, the Sudans, the Kenyans, everybody was calling me. Thank you so much. We are so grateful. We are so grateful. The children and the family of the Kyazze are very grateful for everything you have done for us. We do not take everything for granted. But before I leave this microphone, because I'll not get a chance to come back again, I would like to thank the organizing committee, because I did not work alone with the children. The children were mourning, but they all stuck together and helped, chipped in. But we had a steering committee led by Omukungu, Gladys Kavuma, who is also my big sister, but she's a representative. Yeah, stand up. And we had a coordinator, Mr. Jasper Ntege. Now, he coordinated. We set up three committees, one in the Canada, one in the UK, and one in Uganda, to make sure that the transition is good. We also wanted to include other Canadians, because that's where he started. So that Jasper coordinated the group in Canada, led by Mr. Galabuzi Grace, who was one of Chelsea's best friends. And then in Uganda, it was led by his son, Richard Kyazze, and niece, Yvonne Kyazze. So this committee, plus all the other members of the committee, Mr. and Mrs. Mubiru, please stand up if you can. Henrietta, please. Aisha, love, please. Goodness me, like Bosa is in charge of all this. All of them, Bosa, but some, this did a great job. Our dad looks beautiful because of Mr. Bosa and Pauline Najuma and TB Cripps. Thank you. So before I leave, I thank all the providers, all the service providers, the caterers, the video coverage, the musicians. What would we have done without you? And you look so beautiful. And you sang so beautifully. Thank you so much. The band, led by those, that band is by the young people, led by Richard and Martha. On the way to Jericho. Thank you so much. The organist. And everybody who's taken part in this, there's one young lady called Ruth Ntege. You see this booklet? Ruth Ntege is one of Mr. Chelsea's young youth girls. She said she rose up to the challenge. She said, "Aunt Mubeja, we are not going to hire somebody to do this school. We'll do it." She and the girls sat together and designed this book. After that, we need to appreciate that. She's not that. She's actually doing the presentation of the PowerPoint. That young girl, she's the youngest child of the Ntege family. She's the youngest daughter, child of the Reverend and Mrs. Ntege. So thank you so much. Thank you for coming. Thank you, pastors. Thank you, everybody. Take care of all that we do, because we are so grateful. May Chelsea's soul continue to rest in peace. And as you continue to take care of this body, continue, please, to pray for us. This is part of the journey, and it is still continuing. Thank you very much.
Era ntwala omukisa guno okubanjulira hosti waffe omwawule kati hosti nze wano mwawule bamuzaalira Uganda naye n'akulira e Kenya naye n'atambula okujja e Bungereza. He was born in Uganda near my village next to my house, and he grew. When he started walking, he walked via Busia to Kenya, and from Kenya. He heard that I'm here, so he came here. And when he heard that we are next door, he came next to us here. He will be speaking to us later. May I take this opportunity to just introduce to you Reverend Japheth Kabiru. He would be Mubiru as my Mubiru here. But because he crossed Busia, instead of Mubiru, he became a small Kabiru. So, you'll find out during the reception that we've got a Mubiru and the Kabiru. You see them, trust me. Now, let me call upon Dabi Radio representatives, please. Can you come and just give us a tribute?
I won't say it's an honor to be here, but it's unfortunate that we have to be here. I would like to thank each and every person that's taken your time out to come and pay your respect to Mr. Charles Kyazze. 75W Radio is a community radio station that is creating a therapeutic network to empower our community. We have lost a massive pillar in Mr. Charles Kyazze. His vision, articulate voice, his presence and charisma are some of the things we shall miss. He has been working with 75W Radio to try and bridge those gaps within our community. He has been on the management team. He has been a presenter, a mentor, and he has inspired a lot of people through his programs. Mr. Kyazze has been presenting a program called Chibunomo every Monday at 7 p.m. with Haj Hamza, Sirada, and Ramla Makula. This program talks about current affairs that affect our community. Mr. Kyazze did a lot for the community, and we can't let his hard work and efforts end with him. We call upon all the community to learn something from him and also challenge ourselves to help someone else to continue his legacy. We send our dear condolences to the family, friends, the community at large, and our team and listeners at 75W Radio. Indeed, we have lost a great man. May his soul rest in peace.
Mukama yebaziwe, and assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. He would have been on Eid Day, but he's given his time. However, we are grateful. Let's put our hands together for him. Raymond, may I invite Raymond now, please, so that...
This is my sister Sylvia. I just wanted to thank everyone that's been there for our family, that's been there for Uncle Charles till the end, and thank you for attending. Uncle Charles was like a father to me and my sister. He was literally a brother to our dad, and unfortunately our dad passed away in 1991. So from 1991 till the very end, he was looking after us. He's been a mentor, he's been a support system, he's also been a boss to me at one stage. So this is very, very difficult. It was a very, very difficult time for us, very, very, very difficult. And the bond that me and Uncle Charles had personally was very strong. He literally always used to check up on me, always come to visit me, always used to take me to trips. He used to take us to trips, used to take us around all the time. So it didn't feel like we had a father in absence. It's like we gained a father without even knowing. So again, this is very, very hard. It's a very, very difficult time. When we got the news about him being ill, at first, me and Uncle Charles is bond. We always joke. We always, laugh around. Uncle Charles is a joker. If you know Uncle Charles, he's a guy that will always joke. Who always, he's the kind of person that, you have fun with. You can't take him that serious. So when I found out he was ill, at first, obviously, I said, he'll be fine. He'll be okay. Because, just not taking it serious. Then at one stage, relatives in Uganda were adamant, calling me, calling my mum, calling my sister, adamant, saying, go and visit, go and visit, go and visit. And at the stage when we went to go visit him, at first he was asleep, sat next to him. And then when he woke up and turned around and saw me, he was shocked. He was like, wait, man. He's like, yeah, I'm here, I'm coming to see you. Again, strong man. He told me not to worry. He said, ah, it's nothing, it's just diabetes. Ah, don't worry, don't worry, you know. Then obviously, unfortunately, we found out that it was more serious than just diabetes. And then from finding that out, you know, connecting with Chavia, connecting with Klavako, Auntie Harriet, and Senga, Sarah, and obviously coming to visit him every day, I made it a strong effort to come and see him every day. And I used to live in, we live in North London, so going from North London to Tooting to visit him every day, to the point of him going in the hospice, and it's more peaceful, it feels more peaceful because I was there till the end and I saw him, you know, I saw God take him away at the end. So I'm more at peace with it now. So yeah, he was a strong man. I'm gonna miss his laugh. He had a very unique laugh. I'm gonna miss his voice. I'm gonna miss his jokes. I'm gonna miss him telling me about all the million jobs that he told me that he had. I mean, at one stage he told me he drives a trade, and I was like, you drive a trade? And he kept the straight face, saying, yeah, you know, all these things that he told me he used to do, even though he was joking, do you know what I mean? But he's a warm, loving guy. Do you know what I mean? Very, very warm man. So. Yeah, can see. So yeah, again, appreciate all the support and everything, and yeah, that's it.
Yeah, Charles, msajja abadde asaagasaaga nnyo, naye n'agenda, afa mu by'okusaagasaaga awo, bamulambulako, nja kuba bulungi, bannange. Singuteko ningamba mu byokusaagasaaga osobola okufiirawo nga n'okulokotoka tolokose mu byokusaaga awo nja kutukoka enkya nja kuba bulungi munnawe n'ogenda ofiira ddala nga tolokose kakati n'olunaku bwe luti lwenzijukisa Isaaya nti Yosiya lwe yafa n'alaba Mukama kisoboka olwaleero nno okulaba Yesu. This is a possibility. I was just in Uganda, but Charles slipped away jokingly. People visited him and he was comforting them. Well, it's going to be okay, it's going to be okay. My point is, jokingly, you may pass on without confessing Jesus as Lord and Savior. Jokingly, let's take it serious. Now, may I invite a youth representative, please? Okay, please, come on.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Ruth. I'll be representing the youth today. Speaking on behalf of all of the youth here whose lives were positively affected by Mwami Charles Kyazze, we would sincerely like to say thank you. Thank you, Mr. Kyazze, for investing in us, for creating paths and bridging gaps for us when life seemed hopeless. Without you here, there would be such a massive gap in our community. Thank you for dedicating your life to service and showing us what it is that we need to do for the youth in generations to come after us. You were a representation of light and have left us with a huge job to fulfill. As the youth, we promise to try our best to continue to carry on your torch and spread positivity throughout our community. You created such a huge impact on us, from bringing families with young children from third world countries to the UK to have a better chance at life, to supporting charity events like our very own at PCC and Woodward Mission, Salma 25, and Projects Young, run by the youth. You made groundbreaking change in any life that needed it. You are and will always be loved, the most loving and kind, gentle giant with an iconic voice that spoke nothing but positivity and uttered messages to aid change in the world around him. A humble gentleman, but a friend to the young and to the old. We give God all the glory for how he ministered into the lives of many. It has been an honor knowing him, and he will be sorely missed. Mommy Charles Kyazze, your legacy speaks for itself. All the ladies, gentlemen, and youth gathered here today are witnesses of great works God enabled you to do, as you consistently availed yourself to be the change you wanted to see in the world. As a member of the Ntega family, speaking on behalf of my parents, Reverend Canon Nathan Ntega, Elizabeth Ntega, my brother Richard Ntega, and my sisters Catherine and Rona, for the many decades we have known you as a family, we would like to say that you have truly inspired us and touched our lives as individuals and as a family. Webalenyo Mwami Kyazze, yonna byotukoledde. Twebaza Katonda olw'omulimu ogw'ettendo gw'okoze wumula mirembe ssebo. And just to say that in English, thank you so much for everything you've done for us. We thank the Lord for all the ministry that you brought into our lives, and we pray that you rest in peace.
Yesu yagamba nti bwemunaabagaana okwogera amayinja ganaayogera naye Kyazze akoze omulimu. Tutudde ekimala. May we stand up now, joining the stewards to sing that hymn.
Dr. William Wood, who looked
every occasion. Today we're gathered to celebrate the life of our brother Charles Kyazze. Before I say anything further, I want to take this opportunity to express my deep, deep condolences to the entire family. And it is my prayer that the God of all comfort will comfort them and will comfort us all. As I stand here this afternoon to bring you the sermon, I feel I have lost a son. A son who not only listened to what I taught, but a son who followed through and made an impact in his generation. I am very saddened that Charles is not here. The only comfort that I have, and I believe the family have, is that in his lifetime, he made an impact in his generation. And the testimonies that we hear of the numerous assignments that he was engaged in is all a living testament of the fact that when the Lord sought for a man, Charles was ready to say, "Count me in." Today I want to talk to you about what I've entitled, "Let's Serve God Faithfully While We Have the Life That We Have." Sometimes we take for granted that life will carry on endlessly. But the fact that Charles is no longer here must tell us that there comes a time where we will leave this earth. And once we leave this earth, the question is, where are we going? If you live a life that pleased God, and you live a life that served your generation, you can be guaranteed that you will rest in the bosom of Abraham and spend the rest of your eternal life with God. Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 11 and 12 says, "Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. For God will bring every work to judgment, including every secret thing, whether it's good or evil." That tells me that while we live, we must give God the reverence enough to serve him while we live, and to serve our generation while we live. Ezekiel chapter 22, verse number 30 to 31 says, "So I sought for a man among them who will make a war, and stand in the gap before me on behalf of the land, that I should not destroy it, but I found no one." He continues to say that, "Therefore I have poured out my indignation on them. I have consumed them with the fire of my wrath, and I have recompensed their deeds on their own heads, says the Lord God." This tells me that when God calls us while we live to serve him, we must not only serve him and serve our generation, but we must persevere in our service of him, irrespective of what happens while we live. On occasions like this, we're mourning for our brother, mourning the loss of our brother. On occasions like this, we comfort one another. And on occasions like this, we hear a word from God, like we're hearing right now. But the question is, while we celebrate the life of our brother, Charles, are we going to use this opportunity to reflect on our own lives, so that when the time comes for us to depart from this earth, we will know where we are going, where we are going? I want us to draw some lessons from the life that we are all living and from death, which we know is inevitable and will come to us all. I believe that on occasions like this, yes, we're celebrating the life of our brother, but then this is the opportunity for us to say, where is my life with God right now? And when I move on from this earth today, if God calls me, where will I go? So I believe that reflecting on our own lives on occasions like this is very, very important. Before I begin to give you the points concerning lessons that we can learn while we are alive, I can assure you from the beginning that I'm not going to spend too long. I'm going to cut it short, I'm going to make it succinct, and I believe that by the close of this message, we will know that every change that we need to make in our own lives, we need to make those changes now, so that when the time comes, we will have no regrets on our dying beds. There are many, many people who on their dying beds are asking the Lord, Lord, give me 2 more weeks. Lord, give me 1 more month. Lord, give me 2 more months. But you see, as a Christian, on your dying bed, you should be able to say confidently, my time is up and I'm ready to go. The places you needed to go, you need to go. The things you needed to do, you need to do them now. The people you needed to help, you need to help them now. So that when the time comes, you will have no regrets. You'll say, my time is up, Lord. If it is your will, take me both. What are some of the lessons that we can learn from life and from death? I've got 50 points here, but I'll give you only 12. I'm sure some of you will be very glad to hear that. Point number one, let's put God first while we live. There is something about the United Kingdom. As soon as you land at Heathrow, all service of God goes out of the window and we run after the pound. We need to be very careful about that. The God who brought you to the United Kingdom, the same God who took you to America, the same God who took you to Canada, always remember to continue to serve Him wherever He takes you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Number two, let's be the best we can be while we have life. If you listen carefully to the testimonies that have been given about the life of Charles, he was the best he could be while he lived. And on his dying bed, when I went to visit him, he was encouraging us. He was saying to us, when I come out of this bed, I will continue my radio broadcast. I'll continue to serve God. I'll continue to love people. He was listing the things that he was already doing and was intending to continue. Let's be the best we can be while we live so that we will have no regrets on our dying beds. Number three, let us have the sense of duty, a sense of dedication, a sense of service, and a sense of fidelity while we live. And I'm sure somebody will be saying, what is fidelity? You know, fidelity as a name of a daughter. But fidelity means more than that. Fidelity means a strict observance to a promise that you have made to God. Every promise that you have made to God, especially when you were leaving Africa to come to London, you said to the Lord, when I come to London, I will serve you with all my heart. I will serve you with all my funds. I will serve you with everything that I have until you arrived at Heathrow or Gatwick. So whenever we make a promise to the Lord to serve Him, and we observe to keep that promise, that is called fidelity. If you listen to the testimonies that have been given about Charles, he aimed to do something for God, and he did it. He aimed to serve his generation, and he did it. He aimed to serve his community, and he did it. He aimed to love, and he did it. He aimed to do the things he needed to do, and he did it. Let's have that sense of duty and that sense of service while we live. Number four, let's never waver in our service of the Lord while we live. Today, a lot of people give up so easily. The slightest thing that happens in the congregation that they belong to, they absent themselves and give excuses for it. The slightest thing that happens, they say, Lord, I think I need to walk away. I don't want any trouble. I don't want to serve you anymore. And then they walk away. It's very important to know that when we die, God is the only one who gives the clearance for entry into heaven. If you don't serve Him now while you live, why do you expect Him to open the gates of heaven for you to enter? While we live, may we never waver. And that is why in our ministry over the last 4 months, our theme has been persevering in our service of the Lord. Things will happen while we live, but persevere. Shortages will come while we live, but persevere. Troubles will come while you live, but persevere, and you shall win. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Number five, on the lessons that we can learn. Let's be the pillars for God and for our generation while we live. God is always seeking for a man or a woman to use. God is always looking for a man or a woman to say, yes, Lord, count me in. You brought me into this world. I want to serve you. No matter what comes my way, cause me to continue to serve you. May we be the pillars that God will use in our generation. Those who came before us did what they needed to do. They handed to us the baton, which we are holding right now. What are we doing for God while we hold the baton? Will we be like the talented man, the man who was given one talent, buried the talent because others had five and others had two? He buried his one talent when God wanted to use it while he was alive. May we never waver in our service of the Lord. And may we be the pillars for God in our generation. Number six, let's be the rock upon which God builds his church. He said, I will build my church, and the gates of Hades shall never prevail against it. May we be the pillars, and may we be the rock upon which God builds his church. Rocks never move. Rocks are unmovable. Rocks are unshakable. Rocks always maintain their position where they are. May we not be too quick to leave God and abandon God's service while we live. Number seven, let's be the sons and daughters that God always created us to be. A father is always pleased to see a daughter and a son doing exactly what they were asked to do. A mother is always pleased to see a son and a daughter walking in obedience to the will of the father and the mother. May we be children, sons, and daughters of God who please God. If you please your God, when the time comes for the heavens to be open, for you to enter into rest, you all know the bills that you are paying right now. When the rest of God is opened unto you, no more council tax, no more gas bill, no more electricity, no more parking charges, the ones that you incurred and the ones that they put on you. No more charges. May we be sons and daughters. May we.
Yeah.
Thank you. tugenda kubaayo okusiga tugenda kubaayo olunaku nibasanyu kugeberera stewart katusabe obuweereza bwonna.
Okay,
Colleagues, I want to begin by thanking the Lord for having brought us here today. To bid thee farewell to our loved one,
Charles Kitanda Kyazze.
Karori Kitanda Kyazze.
Anjagala okusoka okubabulira abo abakoze apologies.
I want to begin by presenting to you those who sent in the apologies.
Nalinya Nakabiri Elizabeth.
Lady Nalinya Nakabiri Elizabeth.
Sengaga.
Sengaga.
Tasobodya kubeerawo.
She hasn't been able to be with us.
Naye alina fe moyo.
But she's with us in spirit.
Mwami Edward Lubega.
Mr. Edward Lubega.
Abasaside nyo Harriet ne family.
Sends condolences to Harriet and family. They haven't been able to attend. The representative of His Holiness the King,
Ronald
Mwenda Tebi.
Lutaya.
Ronald Lutaya. Hasn't been able to attend. Please accept his apologies, but he's with us in spirit. I have a message from Thornton Heath Church.
Eri ab'ennyumba y'omugenzi Charles Kitanda Kyazze.
Towards the home of the late Charles Kitanda Kyazze.
Okukubagiza olw'okuviibwako Charles Kitanda Kyazze.
Condolence message for the loss of Charles Kitanda Kyazze.
Kulaba Kristaayo w'ekkanisa y'Oluganda.
On behalf of all the brethren.
Thornton Heath.
In Thornton Heath.
Mtusa okusasira munafo mu Kristaayo Harriet Katerega ne family yonna.
I bring condolence messages to the aforesaid.
Olw'okuviibwako omwami taata.
For the loss of a husband and father.
Kojja ow'Oluganda era omukwano Charles Kyazze.
Uncle, brethren, and friend Charles Kyazze.
Ekkanisa y'Oluganda e Thornton Heath.
The church of all the brethren in Thornton Heath.
Eweereza ekimuli.
Ascend the wreath.
N'olubugo bweti.
And a condolence message as below.
Abakristaayo mu munno mukabi.
All the Christians in that association of Munno Mukabi.
Pound 10 mukone.
110 pounds.
Team ya Yokana.
The team of John.
Omu Harriet mwa weleleza. Ba weleza pound 3.
Where Harriet is a servant, they sent 340?
Yeah. A total nebera poundi bina mwana.
Omugate guna is 440 pounds.
Awubona abaweleza bakristaayo is Thornton Heath.
All that message come from the brethren in Thornton Heath.
Era basasira n'okwenjawulo eri member wawe ne family.
They send a special condolence message to the entire family and all of us.
Nti mukama abakumye.
May the Almighty God strengthen all of us.
Tusasira tutusa okusasira kwaffe.
We express our sympathies towards all the friends and the entire Ugandan community, those who reside and domicile in Uganda, in the United Kingdom,
bracket my Uganda community in UK,
the Ugandan community in the United Kingdom.
Omgenzi, yawereleza ebanga etene nyo.
Where the late has been serving for a very long time. It is our prayer that the Lord grants him
peace.
Amen. Amen. Comfort those who are behind. And that is being countersigned by Gladys Kavuma.
Mukubiriza, Mukanisa Uganda, St. Jude, Nyeden.
The coordinator of the church, St. Jude. That is the end of the message. Dear colleagues, I want to extend my thanks to Harriet. Lady Katerika, for having allowed me to share to ensure that we make preparations for this occasion, this wonderful occasion. We are overjoyed to see all of you. I won't be mentioning people by their names because all have already been mentioned and introduced. I thank particularly the committee for arranging this occasion. Others are already seated in the hall. We want to invite them to come here and meet them and go over to the hall.
Thank you.
before accommodation, we have to pray for your family. And so I request you kindly to sit down for a minute or so we can just have a short prayer for the family. Please, family members, could you please stand together. Almighty and everlasting Father, we thank you because you never do wrong. In taking Charles, you leave behind the family, which all of us direct our hands to bless. In his absence, your presence is assured. And we pray surrounding them all in the name of Jesus, that he may cover them with the power of the Spirit, that the power of evil shall never invade their territories. And we pray for his wife, for the children, for grandchildren, for nieces, for the brothers and sisters, all siblings. And we pray that, Lord, that the friendship and connections in the community and church be made as this family keep their memories. We pray for them in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So you may sit down. I speak very, very briefly. I'm so delighted and also a little bit ashamed for coming late. We had our annual representative session of the Methodist meeting of the London district, which I am a member of, and I couldn't miss. So I just wish to thank my colleagues for steering the way in my absence, and also all those people who have been taking part. That has been very kind of you. Officially, I am the minister of this church and a few others, the Lord Jesus. The most important thing is my Savior. Hallelujah. And for the first time, although in a funeral setting, I am so delighted to see a lot of people from East Africa. I'm so delighted to say to Kitanda Kyazze. So my personal condolences and the Methodist Church here where you are seated, please feel welcome, not only during a funeral setting, but anytime you feel like worshiping with us. So we are going to do the commendation, and we request everyone to stand, and I request all our former colleagues, including Archbishop, please, will you come? We do the commendation together. So let everyone stand as we do the commendation. Commendation, in the Methodist theological perspective, means the last committal, the last sentiment of the blessing which we offer to the departed soul. Almighty, we know Charles Lee for big God. We also know his presence will be missed in the church, and everywhere he has been moving and doing things. We know it is only his body which is here. We know all the promises you have made, that those who die in you do not die but sleep. So we know our brother is asleep. He is not dead, he is asleep in the spirit. And now, dear Lord, as you have also reminded us not to be troubled, because you have made mansions and the rooms for everyone who believes, we know he is occupying his room which he made for him in your eternity. And so we also remember that you say you will never leave us and you will never forsake us. So as you have been with Charles on earth, breathing the oxygen we do, and eating the foods we eat, and speaking the languages we have, since you have said you will never leave us and you will never forsake us, do not forsake him in your eternity. So together we commend his soul to you, and pending the commitment to home in Uganda, praying for the safe travel and every other activity remaining before his final resting place. Hear this prayer, which we make in faith, in the name of our Savior and the Lord, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. God bless you so much, Fendreza. Now the next song.
Mwebale okujja kye kisoboka obukulu ekyokubiri temwerabira okusaba gye musabira noonya buli musumba wuwaali abaana ba Katonda temwerabira okusaba Mukama God ekyengera eky'amasinzizo temwerabira temuvanga ku Mukama. God bless you. Now we are having the band playing and we have to recess now.